Hi, my name is Dan Austin. I'm a registered nurse and also one of the co-founders of CardioWare Science and a co-formulator of Argenetics Cardio. I've been asked to explain and talk to some of the people in the healthcare field about EECP and what we do here at the High Desert Heart Institute with EECP for our patients and how we incorporate Argenetics into the practice of EECP. Dr. Siva was the first interventional cardiologist to bring EECP, which stands for Enhanced External Counterpulsation. He was the first cardiologist to bring it to the High Desert well over 20 years ago. The reason he brought it to our patient population, because we had a large cardiac patient population that were suffering from many forms of types of cardiovascular disease that included angina, that included shortness of breath, fatigue, decreased ability to exercise or engage in any type of activities of daily living, and it was causing their activities of daily living to decrease tremendously. What EECP does is it actually produces nitric oxide, and people don't really realize that it produces nitric oxide. When a patient comes and lays on this bed here, right here, we want to go and we'll put these straps around the patient's calf, thighs, and lower abdomen, and then we'll hook them up to a cardiac monitor. As the machine starts, it will squeeze, okay, the lower extremities, and what it does is that it enhances cardiovascular flow to the coronary arteries. So what it does is it enhances a macrovascular flow, and what it will do is it will increase blood flow and oxygen to the heart and other vital organs, including the brain, the kidneys, the liver, and also what it does is it improves the patient's ability to do what they want to do post-treatment. And when I say post-treatment, these patients come into EECP 1 hour a day, 5 days a week for 7 weeks. And they have been known to have great improvements in their activities of daily living and also have less anginal events with this treatment. Like I said, Dr. Siva has been using EECP therapy for well over 20 years. Other cardiologists in the High Desert have now introduced EECP for their cardiac patients. But what they haven't done is they haven't added, okay, a nitric oxide complex or like Argenetics to their patient's population. And what we do is we actually give this to our patients and have them take it a half an hour to 45 minutes before they come in for treatment. Why? Because if you take a serving of Argenetics, what it does is it will, as a arginine precursor to nitric oxide, it will have a more of a vasodilation, so it'll be on board when they're on the table, and when these press on their legs, you'll get a turbo boost effect, and we actually see a lessening blood pressure pre and post. So what we've been doing now for the last 5 years, if we've been actually doing a meta-analysis data testing on our patients to see how this patient population who has angina, but they also have other cardiovascular disease processes such as atherosclerosis, which means hardening of the arteries. So when they have these disease processes, what we want to do with other key ingredients of the Argenetics, which is MenaQ7, okay, which works on reducing arterial stiffness, in that aspect of it there, what we're doing is we're actually treating, okay, the patient from the outside in and then from the inside out with the precursor arginine to nitric oxide, which relaxes the arteries. So we're getting a double benefit for this patient. And now what you're getting a triple benefit, okay, when they're on EECP. So this is truly, truly, truly maximum benefit for a patient who has a cardiovascular disease and when it doesn't have to cramp their lifestyle. What we've been able to see is after these patients are finishing EECP therapy, what they're coming to me and they're saying, Dan, you know what? I've been able to do the things around my house in half the time. I've been able to go shopping with my wife and I'm pushing the cart, or I'm able to do the things around my house in half the time. So these are the kind of things, the feedback that I as a nurse have been getting from my patients and patients who have been coming and doing EECP. Plus what we're seeing now is when, for example, 6 months ago, Okay, the indications and diagnosis of hypertension went from 140 over 90 to 130 over 80, and it created several million new hypertensive patients. What we've been able to do is we've been able to get those patients below those numbers just by introducing them to our genetics. Thank you.